two of you that subscribe to me that wonder why I haven't posted a video since late December. I'm in the middle of revamping my drum room and the way I record my video. So the next time I put a video out there, hopefully you'll notice it's a lot better quality than what you've been seeing from my channel. So nothing wrong with me health-wise. I've just been revamping and taking my time and making room. I've been tearing down some of the stuff that I had previously and piling stuff in corners. And I'll show you a little bit around my drum room, but I'll be posting videos again probably within the next week or two if you're interested. Thanks. Well, this is my music room. We used to have this room used to be a storage room on the back of our garage. And my wife was gracious in 2015 when I decided to start playing drums again to let us convert this into my music room. So we carpeted it and painted the walls and just made a lot of changes in 3 years. This place called Harbor Freight, I bought all these packing blankets you see on my exterior walls. There's 20 of them. I just tacked them up there in layers. Neighbors used to complain about my drumming because they could hear it in their house, they said. So I tried to accommodate them with these packing blankets, and it seems to be working out okay. That's an old DT Explorer kit that I only use for practice pads these days. As you can see, it's piled up with all the lighting I use in my videos. Most of it's $5 desk lamps from Walmart with colored light bulbs. There's the bag of colored light bulbs that I use right there. It's full of light bulbs. Nothing special, but it's kind of interesting to see the different color combinations I can come up with. Just makes it a little less boring to watch, I hope. That's my intention. That's an old Pearl Forum kit right there I have piled in the corner. I bought that off a friend. I'm just kind of saving it to see if any of my grandkids may be interested in playing someday. One of my grandsons made me that sign for Christmas a couple years ago. I love that sign. Hangs in here all the time. I have a couple Tannoy studio monitor speakers, I should say. There's one, and the other's over here. And then along the back wall, I have a couple JBL monitor speakers. I only use two snares. There's the 10-ply maple snare that came with the kit. People consider those throwaway snares. I don't. I try to match the snare to the cover I'm playing. So I use a maple and this brass right here. This is a pork pie brass snare. Really like that snare too. As you can see from my videos, I use all Zildjian A Customs. I'm happy with the way they record. Good quality cymbals. To me, cymbals are more important than the drums. You can make a cheap drum kit sound good, but you can't make a cheap cymbal sound good. All the hardware is PDP, everything. The rack, all the cymbal stands, the hi-hat stands, the pedals. It's just okay. I'm not so sure I'd want to take it out on the road and use it, but for a stationary kit like this, it works fine for me, especially for the price point. Well, I've got all the room made for the new equipment I'm waiting on, so hopefully it'll be here within the next week or two and I can start pounding out some songs again because I miss playing. Take care, guys. Look forward to watching your videos, too. Bye-bye.